Welcome to another episode of the Hellion Rebellion Rock and Roll Association, brought to you by Holly Geist and my grungy Chewbacca friend. Over the last 3 to 6 months, maybe even close to a year, I've been getting a lot of messages saying do a Cannibal Corpse video. Cannibal Corpse. I have Cannibal Corpse records. I love that band. I've loved them since the very beginning. So I'm going to do one. The thing is the one record of theirs I don't have is a record called Kill that I think is really one of their best records. But I do have a compilation made by Metal Blade, and I believe Death Records might be a part of this, called Deathmeister Volume 1, that has the Kill, I Will Kill You song on it. Which I consider to be a Cannibal Corpse classic. But we're gonna talk about a couple bands since I'm gonna do a compilation. And you know, talking about Metal Blade, I mean it's an independent metal record label that is still around to this day. I mean, hell, these guys are putting out King Diamond, Goat Whore, some serious metal bands. And it's a good platform and jumping off to talk about death metal in general. It's a style of music that really needs to be taken seriously. And I guess it has been taken seriously for a good 20 years now. The fact that Cannibal Corpse is probably the one of the premier death metal bands to this day. It's amazing to me that this band is as big as they are. Well, it's not amazing. They're great. They're a great band. They deserve everything they get. But let's talk about the history of Cannibal Corpse. They're originally from Buffalo, New York. They would move to Tampa Bay, which in the late 80s and early 90s, Tampa Bay was a hot spot and one of the beginnings of death metal in America, with bands like Obituary, Morbid Angel, Deicide. I think Massacre might have been from there. And it's just kind of funny that this kind of music would come from the sunny, beautiful, glam-ridden city of Tampa Bay, second only to Miami. The other big place would have been probably Stockholm, Sweden, where you would find bands like Entombed, Dismember, and there was another real big one that came from there. And their name is eluding me right now. New York, especially Buffalo, would have quite a few death metal bands. Cannibal Corpse. I believe Suffocation. I don't know if they're from Buffalo. They're from New York. And then the state of Illinois had a ton of death metal bands that nobody liked. But they would eventually produce Broken Hope, which was kind of a Cannibal Corpse clone. Great band. I love Broken Hope. And I think Macabre was from Illinois. But Illinois put out a ridiculous amount of death metal that just wasn't great. But it was amazing how many bands were coming out of there. Of course, England had their Napalm Death, and Brazil had its Sepultura. Now, in the very beginning, if you wanted this kind of music, you had to trade tapes with people because nobody took this kind of music seriously. Nobody wanted to sell this. It was violent. The singers didn't really even sing. So you would find people via snail mail through a magazine and say, hey, I want some of that Napalm Death. I'm trying to get some of that Nihilist. I'm trying to get Terrorizer. You know, I'm trying to get Ratos de Pereiro. So you would trade tapes with people to get this kind of music. Death metal was coined, the term death metal was coined by a band called Possessed in the early 80s, who had a song called Death Metal, and they were kind of like this sort of music, but they were lumped in with the thrashers, just like Bathory or Celtic Frost, and they were kind of neck and neck with Slayer, until Slayer put out Rain and Blood or Hell Awaits, and those two records just absolutely destroyed Possessed. Nothing against Possessed. They're a great band. I still listen to them, have a few of their records. But I remember a band called Death, started by Chuck Schuldiner. And again, this was a band that was lumped into all the thrashers, the speed metal people, and all that. But the way he sang was very gurgly. It wasn't really singing. It was very unique and different for its time. And I remember saying, like, when I tried to describe a death metal band, or not even a death metal band, just a metal band to anybody, and somebody would say, well, oh, what does Deceased sound like? I'm like, well, they sound like that band Death, or they're kind of like death metal, because they weren't Anthrax, they weren't Megadeth, they weren't Possessed, they weren't Slayer. It's death metal. It's like that band Death. Have you heard that band? And that's where I started really saying the term death metal. Chuck Schuldiner would eventually go on, and Death, to become one of the most progressive heavy metal bands of the mid to late 90s. And eventually, I don't know what killed Chuck. I think it was leukemia, or maybe it was Hodgkin's lymphoma or something, but he would eventually pass away, and that would be the end of Death. And it's a damn shame, because those guys were way ahead of their time. And not only were they way ahead of their time in the 90s and early 2000s, they were way ahead of their time when they put out their first album that was kind of like death metal. So let's get back to Cannibal Corpse, a band that is loved and endeared to all, a band that has transcended generations of children. After all these years, this is the premier death metal band. Cannibal Corpse's first album came out at the very end of probably the first generation of death metal. It was an album called Eaten Back to Life, and on the cover has a zombie eating its own guts in order to stay alive. It's ridiculous. The music was ridiculous. The lyrics were ridiculous. The artwork was ridiculous. I mean, the whole thing was absolutely ridiculous. I mean, here we are. We are so used to Obituary, Morbid Angel. These bands coming out of Florida. And finally, there's labels like Metal Blade. The other big one would have been Road Runner, RC, Road Racer, the other independent metal label that finally started putting out this kind of music. But when we heard Cannibal Corpse for the first time, I vividly remember my buddy buying this record and saying, I'm going to tell you right now, that is going to be stupid. That looks like a joke. And I believe that was on Death Records, which I think Death Records might still be around. But he was like, no, I'm going to buy this. Even if it's a joke, it's going to be funny, man. And so we listened to Eaten Back to Life, and it is just as death metal as it can get. It's just gurgly. It's so down-tuned. You read the lyrics, if you can't understand the lyrics, and it's just the most ridiculous, gore-filled lyrics I've ever read. I'm like, dude, this is like a comic book, dude. And he would come back to me because he was like, well, you like the Dead Milkmen. Is that a punk band or is that a joke band? I'm like, all right, you got me. But I have to tell you, I mean, Cannibal Corpse, musician-wise, technically, was absolutely amazing. And even though we all thought of this band as a joke, we knew they were going to make some money. They're going to put out two or three records. It's funny as hell. You know, they don't take themselves as seriously as Obituary or Deicide or Morbid Angel. And I remember we'd just sit around and party to this stuff and be like, man, check this out. Well, let's fast forward 30 years. And Cannibal Corpse is the band who really redefined death metal and what death metal is and what you talk about when you do this style of music. And to this day, they sell out shows, and kids 15, 20, 30 years old, if they're into metal, they know who Cannibal Corpse is. So, again, I was going to do Eaten Back to Life. I probably should, since that was my introduction to this band. But I really wanted to advertise and showcase, you know, Metal Blade Records. They were, again, one of the first record labels that really promoted this style of music. And let's go ahead and check out I Will Kill You by Cannibal Corpse. Kill being one of their best records. Fight! 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 All right. I Will Kill You by Cannibal Corpse. Great song. That crushes. Love that record. It's probably the best song on the record, though. The next song on this compilation is a band called Amon Amarth. They get started... Oh, man. Amon Amarth gets started probably in 89, 90, 91. But they weren't really big until probably the late 90s, early 2000s. And this was a group of people who really sort of, I'm not going to say they rode the coattails of death metal, but they learned from the very beginnings of death metal, and they would go on to be a part of what's called the melodic death metal scene. I kind of consider them more of the second generation death metal. But I think this band is way more than death metal. There's moments in their music that sound like Led Zeppelin, Black Sabbath. I mean, even Quiet Riot or a band like that. They get pigeonholed in this whole Viking metal thing because most of their music deals with Norse mythology, Viking mythology. Their name comes from J.R.R. Tolkien's Lord of the Rings. Amon Amarth is like one of the mountain ranges or something in Lord of the Rings. They all have the full beards with the braids and all that. So, I mean, they're pushing an agenda. They're pushing an image. But musically, these guys are amazing. And they're probably the beginnings of the whole melodic death metal thing, which was a style of music that was hearkening back to Sabbath. The early death metal, like Cannibal Corpse, Morbid Angel, was relying a lot on hardcore music, even though they were playing metal riffs and they had more of a heavy metal mentality. Melodic death metal was really paying homage to the heavy metal that came before, that the very beginnings of heavy metal. People like Iron Maiden, people like Dio. So Amon Amarth, again, another band that's still active and around to this day, is one of those great death metal bands that, again, they were put out by Metal Blade Records in the beginning. They're also on this Death Meister Volume 1. So, and they're from Tumba, Sweden. Again, another hot spot for this style of music. I don't know where Tumba is, but I know the Swedish people tend to love this sort of thing. So let's check out Amon Amarth. So there you go, Amon Amarth from Tumba, Sweden. I hope you enjoyed it. Metal Blade Records is a great record company. Always has been. Hopefully they always will be. You know, when they first turned me into a werewolf, they told me I can't turn unless it's, you know, a full moon out and it's nighttime. I had no idea that those urges would come over to me in the middle of the day. I mean, I'm not exactly turning, but I don't know. I think I'm going to have to leave you here today, and I have some raw meat that I need to go eat. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you ladies enjoyed it, and I will see you next time. Thank you.